Welcome to Sip This, a weekly presentation of original comedy from the Tam Valley Players. Those fine folks who bring you the annual Murder Mystery Dinner Theater and the Rhubarb Review. Join us here every Friday night at 7. Be sure to like us on our Facebook page and give us a thumbs up on our YouTube page. Hello, I'm Jeff Brown. You may have seen me in such films as the Star Wars series and Die Hard 2. I usually see the matinee at Northgate and can be found sitting near the back of the theater. It has been my honor and pleasure to act as producer for this little comedy series. What does a producer do, you ask? God only knows. When the Tam Valley Players Community Services District had to cancel Creekside Friday's music festivals because of COVID-19, they asked if we could come up with some sort of online show to present on Friday nights. And of course, we jumped at that chance. So here we are, 9 weeks later. Tonight would have been the final Creekside Friday, and this will be the final edition of Sip This. I would like to thank all the Tam Valley Players who contributed to this effort. Their names will appear in the credits at the end of this video if you can make it through that long. But I would especially like to thank Abby Young, Cass Finwright, John Byrne Berry, and Byrne Healy for their writing talents, Ronan King and Shannon Brown for their production talents, and Carol and Laura and the TCSD for forking out $20 a month to pay for our streaming service. And I would like to thank the 7 or 8 of you that watch us every week. Now please, enjoy the show.
Started. All right, we're going. We're rolling. Welcome to Bronx Beat. We're your hosts, Lorena Chico and Brianna Murphy.
Hello.
So we're going to start this show right off with the elephant in the room.
Yeah, our worst nightmare has come true.
That kids are starting school this year at home.
Yeah, at home on the computer. They call it remote learning.
Yeah, remote, because the chances are remote that they're going to learn anything.
I gotta tell you, classes better not start until 2 o'clock, because that's when they've been getting up for the last 5 months.
Don't get me started. I was just reading something that the school sent out on how to create a productive study space for your children. Oh. Yeah, so get
there. Let me hear it.
Yeah, they said it should be organized.
Why?
Uncluttered.
Oh, really?
Clean.
Uh-huh.
And quiet. So that lets my house out.
My space, the mommy space, better have a full bottle of vodka and noise-canceling headphones in it. That's all I can say.
And I'm so looking forward to helping my children with their homework. You want to know how to get your head torn off? Suggest to a 13-year-old girl that she might want to proofread her paper.
No, thank you. They don't listen to the mothers at this age.
We're the devil.
We're Lucifer.
Satan.
If eye-rolling was an Olympic event, Katie would have already had a gold medal by now.
It's the hormones. They're not so.
Yeah, but, you know, don't get me started on those hormones. Wacko. Absolutely wacko.
It's wacko. Now, the boys, that's different.
Yeah, they're different. You suggest anything to them and they're like, huh?
What? Huh? What?
Exactly. That's exactly how Connor answers every question since he's 11. Huh? What? But they can't help it. They got none of that, executive functioning.
Executive functioning?
Yeah, you know, it's what helps you focus, follow directions, process emotions. Apparently, they don't master it until they're 60.
Mm, lovely. So we got the girls who scream and roll their eyes every time you say something to them, and then the boys just walking around in the fog all day.
They drive us crazy, but
crazy.
We love them.
Oh, no.
Our babies.
Enough with the waterworks. Enough with the waterworks already.
All right. Back to homeschooling, what a nightmare.
Yeah, if you see my kids locked outside the house, mind your own business. We're practicing a fire drill.
Yeah, mind your own beeswax. Everyone's always into everybody's business these days. Yeah. Hey, yesterday I was at the store selecting some cranberry juice, and this woman comes up to me and she says, oh, don't give your kids that. It's all sugar.
Enough with the sugar police.
Yeah, so I says to her, I says, lady, mind your own business. This is for my cosmopolitans.
Yeah, whatever you do, you know, to get you through the day. And speaking about getting through your day, you know where our next homeschool field trip's going to be this year?
No, where?
The laundry room.
That's right. Never too early to teach them the fundamentals of clothes washing, something that my husband Gary never apparently grasped.
Yeah, mine neither. Played hooky that day. Skipped a load in the dishwasher class as well.
But isn't it wonderful having everyone home, all together, all the time, under the same roof?
Wonderful is one way to put it. Another way, dirty, filthy, stinky, sticky. I can go on and on.
It's amazing how much filth and stink four people can create when they're all confined in a space for a prolonged period of time.
It's like living in a zoo.
We're living like animals.
Yeah. All right. Enough. That's all right. We got to find a way to relax. My friend Rita does something called mindful yoga.
What the hell is that?
It's like yoga, but it's mindful.
What the hell does that mean?
I have no idea. You know what kind of yoga I do?
What yoga?
I'll tell you. The kind where you pour yourself a glass of wine, give yourself a manicure, and binge watch Desperate Housewives.
Yeah, you know what? People gotta relax. You gotta have your me time. Have a glass of wine. What do I care?
Have two glasses. Who am I? The police?
Hey, you know what I say? I say smoke them if you got them.
Smoke them if you got them.
And while you're relaxing, enjoy this next skit from the Tam Valley Players.
Good day. In these uncertain times, we must all do our part to minimize the effect of COVID on ourselves and others. And one of the best ways to do this is by wearing a face mask. But I don't have a face mask, you say, and I can't go to the store to purchase one without wearing one. Quite the conundrum, isn't it? I recently found myself in a similar situation. Fortunately, my great-grandson, J. Arthur Brown IV, had recently paid a visit and had left behind some of his diapers. And I thought to myself, what would Alexander Graham Bell have done if faced with a similar predicament? Now granted, Pampers had yet to be invented during Bell's time, but you get the idea. You simply take your scissors and make two holes for the diapers to be held in place by your ears, thusly. Then you simply place the diaper over your mouth, slide the ends over your ears, and voila! Probably should have used a fresh diaper.
Welcome to Celebrity Password. And now, here's your host, Sally Field.
Has a red nose and wears big shoes.
A clap.
Oh, This is long and it runs across the top of the circus tent.
Yarn.
No, it runs across the top of the circus tent.
A flag.
No, it's like yarn, but thicker.
Rope.
Yes, and it's not loose, it's
tight.
And you put them together.
Rope tight.
It's not like yarn, it's thicker, it's
rope.
And it's not loose, it's
tight.
And if you put them together and flip them around,
tight rope.
Oh! I feel like I just landed a plane.
Okay, Rodney, you've got 1 minute on the clock. Go.
parents gave me to play with in the back.
A toaster!
My wife is so cold, this is what she turned our water bed into.
Ice!
This is what my parents tied around my neck so the dog would play with me.
A pork chop!
And this is what the hooker dropped when I dropped my pants.
A price!
This is how I get my steak and sex.
Rare?
Next week when our select